My name is Mili Khamkar and I am lecturer in Pravin Patil College of Diploma Engineering and Technology. We are learning subject fluid mechanics and machinery. In previous two videos, we have seen the chapter fluid flow. Okay, so in previous video, we have started with the continuity equation and Bernoulli's equation. So in this video, we are going to see the applications of Bernoulli's equation. So in this video, previous video, we have discussed that the pressure head plus kinetic head plus potential head is equal to constant, that is P by rho g plus V square by 2g plus z is equal to constant. So in this video, we are going to discuss the applications of Bernoulli's equation. So Bernoulli's equation can be used for measurement of the flow, okay. So Bernoulli's principle can be applied to the device which used for the flow measurement. So the first application is venturi meter, another is orifice meter, and third is a pitot tube. Let's discuss each in details. The first application is venturi meter. The venturi meter is used for the flow measurement which the flow is flowing through the pipe. It consists the main three parts. One is short convergent cone, second is throat, and third is divergent cone. So if you observe here, the venturi meter is attached to the pipe of which the flow is to be measured. So basically it consists of three parts. One is convergent cone, one is throat, and one is divergent cone. So basically conversion cone is nothing but the gradually decreasing area pipe in which the area, if you observe here, the area is larger and area is smaller. So this is convergent type of cone. Then the divergent cone, the area at the inlet is smaller as compared to area at outlet. Then this is a divergent cone. The convergent cone and divergent cone is connected by the throat. The throat is nothing but the simple constant area pipe of the smaller diameter. Then the manometer, which is pressure measuring device, is used for the pressure measurement. The one end of the manometer is connected to the throat and the another end of the manometer is connected to the pipe. In the manometer, the manometric fluid is filled, that is in mercury, or the material which is having the higher density fluid. Okay, then the fluid is flowing through the pipe, enters into the venturi meter through the convergent cone. At the convergent cone, the area is reducing. As the area is reducing, the velocity will increase and the pressure will decrease. At the throat section, the velocity will be the highest. The velocity will be the highest and the pressure would be the lowest. Then at the divergent cone, the area is gradually increases. Then it causes the reduction in velocity and increase in pressure. So basically, this is how you can then the pressure of manometer is being measured, and the using the formula we can calculate the flow by using the formula. Then next is orifice meter. The orifice meter is a device which used for the flow measurement. It works on the same principle as the venturi meter, but the cost of this is cost as compared to venturi meter is less. In this, the orifice meter has an orifice plate. There is a plate which is fitted into pipe and it consists of circular hole which is concentric to the pipe. This hole is called as an orifice. This orifice diameter is generally 0.5 times of diameter of the your main pipe, although it may vary from 0.4 to 0.8 times of the diameter of the pipe. As the as the fluid is flowing through the pipe, cause due to interruption because of the orifice plate, it causes the reduction in area and increasing in the velocity as well as the pressure. So at the both side, before your orifice meter and after the orifice meter, the differential pressure measurement instrument, that is a manometer, is attached to it so that it could measure the pressure, and the pressure value can be used for the formula of your flow measurement. Third is a pitot tube. In the pitot tube, the flow is measured with the help of pitot tube. In the pitot tube, if you observe here, it is a simple type of tube. It is a glass tube which is inserted into the pipe which the flow is to be measured. At the one, the both lines are perpendicular to each other. The fluid flowing through the pipe passes through the pitot tube horizontal section, causes the stagnation point, and it causes the stagnant pressure. And due to stagnant pressure, the height of the fluid will rises into the vertical tube. This height will be measured and used in the flow measurement formula. So this is how you can calculate the flow measurement using the pitot tube, orifice meter, and venturi meter. So I hope this concept is clear to you. Thank you and stay safe.